Hello, and welcome to the VIB quick tip video, how to remotely connect to your T-Bird 5800 using our Smart Access Anywhere software. We begin today's video on the main boot up page when you power on your T-Bird 5800. And all the settings that you're going to need to configure in order to connect to Smart Access Anywhere will be configured in your system options up here in the top left-hand corner. The first thing that you'll want to do from the main system page will be to go and connect to an outside internet network. And you can do this in two different ways. First being using your LAN port, which is the management port on the right side plate of your 5800. Or you could use your Wi-Fi adapter, which is what I'll be using for today's demo. First thing you'll do is just click this checkbox to make sure that's enabled. Find your wireless network that you want to connect to. Click on it. And then you'll be prompted to input a password. And then you'll know that you've successfully connected to this Wi-Fi by obtaining an IP address over here on the right-hand side. Once you get connected, you'll then return back to the main system menu and enter into the remote icon. From here, you'll see our options if you wanted to name it and have a remote access password enabled. That would be for the VNC. Or down here, you'll see the Smart Access Anywhere option. So what you'll do is just hit the connect button. And what the instrument is now doing is connecting to our Smart Access Anywhere cloud solution, which will then give us a code, which then allow us to log into Smart Access Anywhere from any public network. You won't necessarily have to be on an internal LAN or the same Wi-Fi network. And usually takes a second to obtain that access code, because it does have to connect to our server and then pull that information. While it is obtaining that code, I will say that there are three different variations of our Smart Access Anywhere software. The version I'm using today, which is for your PC, but we also have versions both for iOS and Android so that you can remote control using your phone or tablet. You can now see that we have obtained this access code. So what I would do in terms of the PC software is when I install the Smart Access Anywhere software, the first page that'll pop up is what we're looking at right here. I'm using the IP address because I'm using my own home Wi-Fi and everything's on the same network. But if you were looking to remote control it from through the public internet, you would just input that access code that you obtained into this field. And then once it successfully connects, it'll switch over to this page and give you the two main options that you can use using Smart Access Anywhere. The first being the remote screen, which is what gives us the full remote control of the instrument. But you also have a file transfer screen that allows you to either download files from the instrument on your PC or upload files like a test configuration onto the actual instrument. Thank you for your time.